Hey, this is Jen Healy. I'm coming back with some radical self-care practices for radiant health. And I'm calling them radical because they're such basic things that we forget to do each day that can make a dramatic impact and difference in the quality of our lives. So I'm calling them radical so that we can remember how important it is to do these basics and take really good care of ourselves, especially now. We really want to keep ourselves in optimal radiant health to have the greatest impact on the people around us, to be able to boost our immune systems and keep ourselves healthy and strong so we can be available, so we can help out others, and we can also uplift the spirit and the mood of everyone around us as they continue to navigate these unusual times. So I'm going to continue with a series of called Just 5 Minutes, where every day I'm going to share a video that in just 5 minutes you can change your mood, your attitude, your overall health, your sense of well-being. It's so important to take this time, and we only need 5 minutes. I usually recommend taking 5 minutes every hour and move the body. Take frequent breaks, especially if you're working from home right now. And you're feeling pretty cooped up, it's still okay to go outside. It's actually really important to get sunshine and be in nature and feel the trees and feel the energy around us. We are very much in tune and connected to nature, so the more time we spend with nature, the better. And when you take these 5 minute breaks and move your body, you can help to rejuvenate and circulate and revitalize your systems. So I recommend walking around the block, doing jumping jacks. If you have one of my delicious swings, get in the yoga swing and hang upside down. It'll literally change your life to just take 5 minutes and do these exercises every hour. And in addition to that, it's important to drink water, lots of good nourishing, hydrating water, just simple water. It's actually good to actually add some minerals to it too, but we'll get to that. So if you're drinking a glass of water every hour, you're going to have to get up and pee every hour. We're going to keep flushing the lymph and flushing the body. This will help with circulation and conductivity. Most people are so deeply dehydrated and they don't even know it. So drink a glass of water every hour, get up every hour, take just 5 minutes to move the body. It will truly be life-changing on how well of an impact it has on your life and on your health. So one of the things that I do as a practice, I'm going to do like this overall video of all the techniques, all of the practices, everything I recommend. So I'm just going to go down this list for you guys. One of the things I do every day is I look for things that inspire me. So I watch something, I listen to something, I read something. In just 5 minutes, you can totally shift your whole perspective and your state by surrounding yourself with things that are uplifting and inspiring. So that's really important. Surround yourself with things that are bringing you positivity, especially now during these times, is going to be uber important to change your mood and lift your spirits. There's a lot of energy and a lot of information coming at us, and we want to selectively sift through that and at least spend 5 minutes each day with something that's going to inspire you and uplift you. It's important to be informed and to be educated about what's going on right now, but it's also important to keep yourself in a good, high place and lift your spirits. So I have this practice that I love that I do that was inspired by Tony Robbins. He's one of my favorite teachers. And it's called a thriving practice. And you can do this in 5 or 10 minutes, and you can do this anywhere, which is super important. So you want to focus on things that you're grateful for. So saying thank you. You can start out just 1 minute saying thank you, body, thank you, breath, thank you, being. Thank you, home. Thank you, friends. Thank you, job. Whatever it is that you're grateful for. And then spend a minute with a thriving practice. So thriving means visualizing how you can see yourself thriving, moving out in the next 6 hours, moving out in the world in the next 6 days, in the next 6 months, in the next 6 years. Just visualize yourself thriving in your life, in your world, actualizing your dreams, taking time to really visualize things going really, really well for you. It's super important. And then the last part of the thriving practice is to love more. So I usually send love out to all the people, places, and things that are important to me in my life. And I usually phrase it as I can love my body more, I can love my breath more, I can love my being more, I can love my home more, I can love my friends more. I just go on and on like that. And I can love them even more. Even if it's a situation in the past that feels unresolved, you can send love to it. You can send love back to it in order to get into a good feeling place. And after doing this for 5 or 10 minutes, I recommend at least 5. If you can do 10, that would be even better. So you could spend 3 minutes doing each one of these practices. It'll really uplift your spirit and change your mood. And this is really important for our radical self-care. Why is it so important to pay attention to our mood? Well, that affects our hormones, it affects our energy levels, it even affects our sleep, right? And the other things that affect this are what we're eating. So it's really important to make sure that you are nourishing your body with lots of good, yummy nutrients. And nutrients can come in many, many forms, and you can consult me or someone else if you need help with nutritional healing in your diet. But really, superfoods are one of the most important things and life hacks that I do every day in my life. So, superfoods are nutrient-dense foods. You can add them to your smoothie or latte or anything like that. So, I recommend just one meal a day, have it jam-packed with superfoods, and give yourself nutrients and vitality so your body can function well. In addition to that, it's important to take supplements. We want to supplement the body, particularly in this day and age with how much stress we're experiencing, how much our food is deficient in minerals and other important enzymes. It's really important to supplement your body with minerals, aminos, and enzymes, and these different superfoods that I love. And I'll make a list of them in the description here so you can follow along if you want to start adding them to your diet. One of the most important things that we can do is just breathe, right? Every 15, 20 minutes, just take a 1 minute breath, constant, conscious breath break. So that looks like, you could be driving, you could be in the line at a store, you can be doing anything, and you just take 1 minute of conscious breathing. And I'm gonna do one video of just 5 minutes on breathing techniques. And so keep an eye out for that. That'll be coming up next. So breathe. Just remember to take 1 minute and breathe like 3 or 4 times an hour. Just take a minute. Take a minute of conscious breathing. It'll change your world. It'll change your life. It'll oxygenate the body. It'll bring more vitality to your systems and energize you. And then, of course, if you can, meditate twice a day. Now, everyone can meditate, but this just means sitting for 5 minutes. 10 minutes is even better. 15 minutes would be wonderful, but at least 5 minutes. Just sit and meditate. You can just sit in silence, quiet your mind, and be receptive. You don't have to think about anything. You don't have to do anything. If you're really interested in learning some more meditation techniques, I have an entire course to help you learn how to meditate in these very specific ways that I call core activations. But simple, transcendental, Zen, Vipassana style meditation, where you're just sitting in quietude, breathing and feeling and being receptive is enough. So, meditating every morning at night, this will help reset your system. Start your day that way and end your day that way. So, you're clearing out. Super duper important. So, if you can, it's really important to get some sort of body work, healing, therapy, coaching every week. This will completely change your life. Now, it can be any style that you like. It can be anything that you're interested in. In fact, you can rotate through. In 1 week, you can get a massage, and then the next week, you can go to talk therapy, and then the next week after that, you can get some empowerment coaching, and then the next week after that, you can try some quantum healing. You can mix it up. But it's super duper important that every single week that you do something really nourishing for your soul, including your body, including your mind, including your spirit. So I highly recommend incorporating that into your radical self-care program. And even if you feel like there's some sort of lack of time, lack of money, lack of resources, lack of energy, we're going to start eliminating some of these popular excuses that exist that are real, but they exist in our society that keep us limited. And we're going to get creative with it, which means you could even do something online, or you could do a trade with someone, but there are ways for you to take care of yourself, and there is a way. So get creative with figuring out how you can make time for this and make it affordable for you so that you're investing in yourself. It's super duper important that you give yourself that time. And one thing you can do that's absolutely easy and accessible for most people is to take a bath or take a hot tub or, take a long steamy shower or get into a sauna. And I recommend doing this 3 or 4 times a week. So, doing this as often as possible, I take a hot tub every morning to start my day, and that's how I meditate. Take a hot tub and then meditate, and it just sets my tone for the entire day so I can be available and then I can show up in the world and come full. And even though it might just take 5 or 10 minutes, it'll change everything. So, give yourself that time. It doesn't have to be a half hour, it could just be 5 or 10 minutes, and it'll make a huge difference. In addition to that, it's really important to move the body and have fun. So, dancing, listening to music, singing, taking a fun class. At least once a week, allow yourself to get into the habit of moving your body in a way that's really fun. I, of course, love to dance, but I also love to do my yoga swing. So, the yoga swings are like fun fitness for me. And if it isn't fun, then change it. Make it fun or switch it up. Do it outside. Make it interesting. But taking a fun class or going dancing each week is really important to uplift our spirit and stay connected to our soulful energy. Plus, you get good exercise. And during these times, especially, remember to connect. So, when we connect with people, it really is this sense of having community and a sense of having that wellspring of love in our lives and to share that love. So, make sure that you're staying connected at least once a day. Reach out to a friend, a loved one, a relative, a neighbor, and have quality time with one another. Really say the important things, really share from the heart, express kindness. Do random acts of kindness or just for no reason, do something nice for someone. Even offering them a smile, a stranger a smile, can make a huge difference right now. It adds up, it's accumulative. Okay? One of the things that I really recommend doing is finding a mentor. Now, finding someone, it doesn't even have to be a coach like Tony Robbins, although I love these high-level mentors that you can find online and they have lots of videos on YouTube. But having someone, an older person, or someone you look up to that you can be inspired by, these little things that will impact your life in a huge way. That's why I'm calling it radical self-care. That you can do the smallest little thing to shift your perspective, to shift the way that you're feeling, and surrounding yourself with people that are inspiring and uplifting you is huge. So find a mentor, find somebody that you could even volunteer with and help out with, especially an older person that might be feeling lonely or might be feeling isolated. Even if it's on FaceTime or a video or just, hanging out at a safe distance right now with all this stuff, but find somebody that you really admire and spend some time with them. It'll make a huge difference. I'm going to end with just a few more really basic things that are important to me. This list is endless. I'm going to really put it in, I'm going to share it with you guys and put it in the comments, but I really invite you to add in the comments the things that are most important to you too, because I listed 22 here. But I really encourage everyone to laugh and to play and to enjoy life a little bit more, especially now. Watch something funny, like create more smiles and humor and playfulness in our lives. It's so important that we take time to love one another and especially love ourselves and to do the things that we love. We have to remember that that kind of self-care is not only going to boost our energy levels and boost our spirits, but we come full and then we overflow and we have more to offer other people. And that's so important that we come full, especially as women. If you tend to be a caretaker and you have a lot on your plate, kids, family, job, etc., there is a tendency for women to put themselves last. And it's really important that we all collectively take really good care of ourselves so we have more to offer, so that we're coming in optimal, radiant health. And with that, take time to relax. Now, since people have this unusual schedule and we're staying at home for this little outbreak, this big outbreak that's going on, these shifts and changes are allowing us to reset and rethink how we're spending our time, what's really important, so eliminate the junk, the junk TV, the shows that are not necessarily filling and fueling your soul. Like, eliminate those things that could be toxic, whether it be food or people or places or things. But take the time, make sure that you are filling yourself with good, wholesome nutrients and positivity. It makes a huge difference for the quality of our lives. If you can, even if you can't do it now, plan something enjoyable and fun for the near future. Sometimes that can be a trip, sometimes that can be an event, but sometimes that could just be a special occasion that you're planning for yourself. And lastly, it's super important to have me time. So I call it me time, where at least 1 hour, if you can manage it. I know that seems like a lot in this crazy world with all these other obligations and things to do and take care of. If you can spend either first thing in the morning or last thing at night just having me time, it will make a tremendous difference for the quality of your life. I really appreciate you listening to this list of radical self-care tips. I am Jen Healy, and you can find out more about my practices at zenhealing.com. That's spelled with an HEALYNG. Dot com. There's no I. Or you can go to transformationaltraining.online and find out more about my courses. I have a free month of radical self-care practices for you to enjoy, as well as meditation techniques. I will be back with some more videos talking about the Just 5 Minutes series that you can do to make real positive change and impact on your health and well-being. I'll see you next time.